ladies and gentlemen, this is Robert Deluxe Gaming, and welcome back to FortressCraft Evolved, Day 23. Jim Bob, the sun is just coming over top of the tree. The tree is getting bigger. Look, you can barely see the sun through the tree. So, yes, Jim Bob has been getting a little lonely. He's been feeling a little sad and crowded because I've been building all sorts of machines around him. It's also getting a little warm. Not that that's really an issue. He is more upset than anything else because I did kick out his family. His family was here late at night eating food out of my fridge. So, yeah, I got a little upset about that. And then, yeah, now he's kind of pouting. So I figured today, why don't we build him a friend? I was thinking about the pumpkin torch. And I will name him... Hold on, let's build him first. I've never built one of these. I'm assuming that they glow too as well. It's a torch, right? So let's see. Let's put this on our bar. This way, Jim Bob has somebody to talk to. And we will put him on a pedestal as well. Maybe right beside Jim Bob. You know, adds ambiance. Here we go. Ooh, that's pretty. Ah, that's really nice, actually. That's really cool. Let's not put him right beside Jim Bob because I think, I don't know, they need to get to know each other first. So let's have them facing each other. I don't know why I get amused by stuff like this, but I do. Okay, so there we go. You will henceforth be known as Casey. Casey and Jim Bob. Very cool. All right, guys, I have a lot to cover today because as you can see, I've been doing a lot of stuff on my own because that's the only way to do this. Honestly, I've been trying to show you guys things as I discover it, but that's not working because... There's no good help in this game. You have to build things and figure it out that way. There's no other way to do it. So here, shall we start with defense? So this thing here, this machine here is the new missile manufactory. Now, this may be a temporary location. I don't know. It's not complete yet. So we have two parts to the basic missile manufactory. We have the empty missile assembler and we have the missile fueler. Now the empty missile assembler takes gold wire and copper pipe. The copper pipe is built with, remember that pipe extruder plant from the very, very, very beginning? That machine that we never built because we didn't know what to do with it. I don't know why you can build it at the beginning if you can't use it, right? I mean, why bother, right? But yeah, this thing, the pipe extrusion plant. We had to build one of those and we built one extrusion plant. Sorry, we built a pipe extrusion plant to make copper pipe and we built an extrusion plant to turn copper or gold bars into gold wire. Now those two combined creates... Da-da-da-da! Hold on. I actually have these locked right now because I wanted to... Didn't want them to actually do anything quite yet. Hold on. There we go. So now they are manufacturing, assembling empty missiles. So it will assemble an empty missile and deposit it in this storage hopper. And then it's going to go from here over to here. This is going to be set as remove only. This is going to be remove only. Now this machine... I don't know what that's going to look like. I've never actually seen them yet. So this machine takes empty missiles and fills them up with fuel and then spits them out. It'll spit them out right here. As soon as I need another storage hopper. We'll get that in a second. But yeah, so now the problem is we don't have, so it needs, let's see, it needs high energy composite fuel. I have no idea what that is. Oh, we have empty missiles. Perfect. Oh, there's one. Yeah, empty missiles. That would be an empty missile. Very, very cool. All right, so yeah, in order for us to fill the missile with fuel, we need something called high energy composite fuel. So on that note, if you remember last time, we were working on the... I can't even remember what it's called now. I'll know after I see this other research, I think. Yeah, we were working on Ultimate Power Grid, the Power Grid, Advanced Power Grid. Anyway, we finished that research. All that gave us... I did finish it because I just wanted to get it done. All that gave us was, the only thing that gave us was the power store, no. No, it's something we have to research, sorry. There's so much stuff, it's hard to keep track of it all. It gave us access to the Mark IV battery component. Mark IV? What happened to Mark III? I'm missing, I mean, I guess we have Mark III, I don't know. But whatever, I guess we've already passed Tier 3, I guess we've already been working with Tier 3. But anyway, this thing stores up to 270, 270, I can't even say it, 270,000 units of power. But it is a 3x3x3, so it's 27 blocks. It's going to be kind of like the lab, you build it in the same way that you build the lab. So that's going to be a big block, and it can store a lot of power. But I'm sure we can't build it quite yet. So anyway, I moved on to researching hydrocarbon recombination, because I have a feeling that's what's going to give us access to better power. I think we're going to be able, I think we're going to be able to turn biomass into some sort of power source. And that's what's going to be able to, that's what we're going to be able to put into these empty missiles. And then we can actually attach that to a missile launcher and then launch missiles at the bad guys, which are getting just intensely crazy stupid. We had our threat level was over 2,000. Over 2,000! Over 9,000! No, over 2,000. It's down to 1,584 because I just finished rebuilding my plant that builds enriched coal. As you can see, it's getting really complex. It's not really that complex at all, actually. It's pretty simple. It's just, you know, coal goes in one side and enriched coal comes out the other. It's just, there's a lot of enrichers here, and there's still not enough to cover our base. Like, we need a lot of these things. I'm probably going to have to build a whole separate power area or a coal enrichment area if we continue to use coal. Maybe there's going to be a better source of power, which I think there will be. There's so much to cover here. So, with the bad guys coming in, right this minute, actually, they're coming in. So, I've got a surprise for you guys. I'm prepared to build turret Mark 3s. I can build four of them. So, these have long range, 72 meters versus the Mark 2s, which is 20. That is substantially more range. That is more than three times the range of a Mark 2. And they, slow firing, but high damage. So, and requires power, of course. So, I can build four of these. One, two, three, four. And then I'm gonna get, I had to use pristine faceted eyes. I've got tons of this stuff kicking around, man. I've been just collecting hordes of it. So where's the bad guys? We want to test one of these suckers out. I know we're under attack. Where are they? I'm sure we're under attack. I thought I timed this so that we've got attack estimated in 10 minutes. Oh. Maybe the last attack is over. Okay, well, that's fine. I've got lots of other stuff to show you guys, so not a big deal. So, minecarts. Oh, yeah, another thing. Honestly, we can't process all of that, all of the bug parts. We can't process it fast enough. So, I ended up with piles and piles and piles of ruined bug parts and stuff. But I live and learn, right? So, the minecarts. Now, I didn't really have a good place to use minecart. Yeah, see all this ruined stuff. I didn't really have a good place to use minecarts quite yet. Effectively. So, I did actually, but I wanted to set it up so that we could actually take a look at it and see how it all works, or at least so I could see how it all works. I mean, so many of you guys watching probably have already played a lot of this game, but myself, I'm still pretty new to this. So, I have prepared, remember our little lithium area? It's, you know, it's a fairly long haul. You know, basically all this stuff was coming up over, like, through the, on the ceiling on a conveyor, right? Which, I don't know, it always bothered me that it was on the ceiling, but it doesn't really matter, but whatever. So instead, I have placed, in preparation for today, I've placed some minecart tracks. Isn't that cool? So yeah, you can have a sloping track too as well. So I'm assuming that they don't move very fast on the slope, or could I even put them going vertically? I doubt it, because there's other things that go vertically. Maybe they're just really slow vertically. I don't know. But anyway, so anyway, you have to have, just to put, lay it all out here. So you have to have a track. You have to have a place to load your minecart. So this is a loader, this thing here. This thing has to be attached to a storage hopper. Storage hopper is on the underneath of it, actually. I don't even know if you guys can see it. I just want you to, the best option was to have the storage hopper underneath it. So yeah, you can see it there. Storage hopper is underneath it and it's attached to the mine. So yeah, perfect. So let me just refill this hole here, because I actually took out some of that track there by accident. Did not mean to do that. So let's put that track back. There we go. And then from the storage hopper, it gets loaded into this, into this thing, and then it gets loaded into one of the minecarts, which will ride on the track, and then get unloaded on the other side. And I'm going to show you that in a second. But this thing here, you also have to have this thing, which is how you load. It's called the, it's called the minecart depot. This thing is a minecart depot. And this thing is how you load minecarts onto your track. And it also has to be attached to a storage hopper. So I have three minecarts on me. So we're going to put one at a time. We're going to go Control-T. And there we go. Minecarts getting put onto the track. Now, I just want to point out that this is like the first iteration of the minecart. They're very, very slow. I'm assuming they get faster than this. Now, each of these minecarts, we can read it here, they can store, hold on, actually probably go to help here. Each of these can store 25, so they only pick up and drop off 25 at a time. Max speed is 1 meter per second acceleration, 0.5 meter per second squared. So it's very, very slow. Minecart usage is straightforward and simply expands on the hopper conveyor paradigm that has been used until now. Minecarts are loaded onto your minecart network via minecart depot. Pretty straightforward. So we're gonna gonna load three of these guys on here just because. Now, I don't know if there was a way for me to change the starting direction, but yeah, they just seem to be going that way. Maybe it's the direction of the track, maybe? That could be it. That could be it. Could very well be it. So we'll load the other one here. So get them all the way. Let's go all the way down. They are super slow. Oh. Uh-oh. Do I have a problem with the track here? Oh, no. Maybe it just looked funny. It does look funny here, doesn't it? Looks like maybe I got it backwards. Okay, sorry. I got to see what... I think I've got the track on backwards over here. You can't... Is there a way to tell which direction this thing's going? I mean, aside from this kind of issue, like, is there another way to tell? Like, is it going to turn around here now? No? No, I guess it doesn't really matter. As long as it's... Yeah, as long as it's either going, you know... this way or this way, it should be good to go. So I guess it doesn't really matter if it's facing, like if you're pointing a certain direction when you put this track down. So yeah, it goes to the end. And then what? Oh, I think actually. Oh, the minecart just fell right off. Oh, whoa, that's not what I wanted. I know why, guys, sorry. See, this, I tried to get prepared today because I knew that I was gonna run into trouble and I just want to prevent as much of that as possible. So I've got curved blocks, curved pieces of track that I completely forgot about. Ah, there we go, so it goes like that. Now, I don't think it'll turn around. Maybe it will. So this is where it unloads. Now, I don't know if it's going to turn around. Ugh. So all of those minecarts are actually now in my backpack. Fantastic. Oh, okay. So just give me one sec and I'll come back to you. Okay, here it comes. Yay, it took a long time for him to get here. They move so slow. We definitely need to research better minecarts. So here it should unload and then it just drops off. Okay, so that answers that question. So basically, you have to build a track that goes all the way from one end to the other. Like, there is no... Oh, and yeah, I'm gonna have to put curves here too as well. Okay, I'll be right back with you guys. Okay, I think I've got it here. So you have to make sure everything is perfectly lined up and they have to stay on their track. If anything is wrong, they will actually fall off the track and you'll have to go pick up the minecart again and then put it back on the track through the depot. So it is a bit of a pain in the butt. You've got to make sure it's 100% correct. Good thing to double check your work, because what had happened to me... So this is working fine. So they will come here and they will unload their stuff into this storage hopper. Then it's going to go up this conveyor. And I just wanted to see if this would work. And I don't know if you could do a vertical system or not. I haven't tested that yet. Maybe that's the next thing I'll test. I doubt that you can. Yeah, I mean, maybe it's possible, but you can't change a horizontal system into a vertical system. The only thing you can do is use these slopes. So you could make things go up or down a really steep slope, I guess, or up this slope, you know, and how many meters could you do that? I don't know. I guess if you've got the length, you could go as far as you wanted, I think. So we're about to see. I haven't actually seen this work yet, because the last time I had this thing, oh right, this thing was turned. Hold on. Yeah, the last time I had it turned incorrectly, so I had it like that. There we go. So now it's in there. It's loading. Oh no, it didn't load. What's going on? Oh, I had it wrong again. Oh, man. Okay, next one should be up here pretty soon. Yeah, so you have to make sure that that track is perfectly in line. Otherwise, see, it just hops off. Here it goes. Load up. Come on, load up. I want to show the folks at home that have never seen this before. There we go. Yeah, it's loading up. Look at that. Kind of a bad angle to look at it, but yeah, that's cool. So it loads up with 25 items, and then, yeah, so I guess they get multiple carts at the same time can load. So the advantage here is the amount of carts that you can have going, and it looks like they go up the slope a lot more slowly than they do, you know, going on the straightaway. Maybe it's the same speed, but it looks like it's more slow, for sure. Cool. Okay, so that's, whoops. Now I can't get back up. Woo! There we go. All right, so now I'm going to put this last minecart back on here. I'm really glad I got this working. Although, like I said, at this point in time, did I need to do a minecart down here? No, this is like a huge waste of resources. Because these use organics too as well. And organics are one of those things that you kind of have to manually, you know, seek out. It's not something that is, you know, just that you mine, right? It's something that you have to manually seek out. So, yeah, this is working. I mean, all it's going to do is take my lithium from the back end and bring it to the front end here, and then it's going to go back up on a conveyor. Now, the next thing to test is to see if we could actually get this running on a vertical. So maybe I'll just do a quick test to see if that works. Be right back. All right, so let's see if this thing works vertically. I mean, I don't see why it wouldn't. I mean, it's a pretty slow system, I think. I don't know. I guess we'll see. Here it goes. Didn't like that at all. Did not like that at all. Hold on, let's try that again. It's thinking. It wants to... No, it doesn't. So it's trying to put it on top of the... Yeah, it doesn't like that at all. So I don't think these things are meant to be used vertically, only horizontally. I mean, if I'm wrong, let me know in the comments below, because I mean, I'm wondering, like, there's some fun things we could do with, you know, maybe these pieces here. Like, we go up and then we go, no, I don't know, maybe, or I don't know, could we, I don't, like that, would that work? Probably not. Well, maybe. Because then we might be able to manipulate it a little bit. I don't know. But either way, I will play with them a little bit more. At this point, like I said, I don't have a lot of use for this kind of system. Eventually... Oh yeah, we got to get back upstairs because we're under attack. And I want to show you guys the new weapons. So so I will meet you up there. Just give me a sec. Okay, as I suspected, it's pretty heated up here. It's pretty intense. So let's put down one of our new turrets without further ado, because we're going to be in big trouble otherwise. Ooh, very nice, very nice. All right, let's get busy here. Let's help out as much as we can. So that's a big turret. So does it just shoot like everything else? It looks like it shoots exactly the same way everything else does. Apparently does a ton more damage. Uh-oh, we're running out of power. I bet you that thing just sucks the life out of this base. It's gonna require a lot of power. I know it will. Oh, 3,600. Did I just see 3,600 points of damage? That's crazy. Did I see 3,600? Wow. Except I wish it would, like, point and shoot at this guy, because we got up here way too late. Man. Okay, so it's pretty, and it does a lot of damage, but it just sucks the power out of the base. I suspected that this might happen, so I did kind of prepare something. All right, so... not in time, of course, because, well, I tried, guys. Okay, you can stop showing me that. Okay, so I'm going to change this now to the center one is going to be... I need bedrock. So I need bedrock to make all this concrete. So that's why I've been using other types of blocks. So I now have the Mark III laser, which transmits a lot more power. So that should keep that thing beefed up pretty quickly. Look at that. Wow. Super fast. But can this node survive? Like, this node, I mean, actually should do okay, but I might have to change out the center power storage blocks to mark power storage blocks 3, because they may not share the power quite as well as the power storage block 3s will need to. So this one can transmit at an enormous amount of power. If we look at it here, so we go eat, it can transmit at up to 320 320 per second. Wow, I just can't believe the numbers that we're starting to deal with. 320 per second, 270,000 for that Mark IV power storage block. Oh, in case you're all wondering, yes, I did put a new explosive back in our little explosive spot. We're gonna let it charge for as long as we possibly can. I wanna see that thing, like, blow, like, totally blow. I wanna, like, I don't know, we're gonna blow up. There's a big mountain over here I would love to blow up. Of course, a mountain over here I'd love to blow up. And we wanna blow up those overmine things, the big wormy things too as well. Okay, one sec, I'll be right back. Okay, the next thing we're gonna try and take a look at, I don't know if I can get it to work or not, I just built the parts for it, is the cargo lift. So I just happen to have this little spot here. This was our original shaft for our iron mine and our lithium mine, and it's perfect size for a cargo shaft, which has to be 3x3. Now, how does this work? I have no idea. So here's the information I have, actually. Let's go, whoa, sorry. There we go. Let's just go to the manufacturer here, and I'll just show you what we have. So we've got the basic cargo lift. This is deploy in a lift controller, affectionately referred to as lift face. Set a body boat face. Yeah. Anyway, and then we have the rack railer, which is related to it somehow. I don't know how yet. And then we have the cargo lift controller. Build in a 3x1x3 shape above a 3x3 shaft to automatically deploy into a lift. So I'm assuming that we just wait. Does it say deploy above? Yeah, above. Okay, so how far above? I don't know. This is why it's almost impossible for me to do this stuff on the fly. I almost have to do it before I get you guys. Like, I almost have to test it out before we do a recording, because I don't know what we're gonna... I mean, I have no idea what to expect. So, let's put this on our bar. So, they don't have the graphics for it. So, I did 9 lift controllers, because I think this is how it works. So, we go 1. Whoops, that's not... That's rock. Okay, 1, 2, 3... 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Aha! So we'll probably want to put that higher. Cargo lift controller, power state, out of power. Operating state, installing rails. So rails, I assume we have to put the rail, we put the rails in the thing and the something and the, I, God. Did we even build a rail? We didn't build... I need 4 macerators. 4 macerators to build 1 rack railer. And I did get the stuff ready for that. So don't you fret. If you think, oh, he's not prepared. Well, I'm mostly not prepared. But there is some things I actually got ready. So macerators. Yeah, so I got 4, 2, 3, 4. Now we can build 1... 1 rack railer. Expensive piece of equipment. And then we're going to stick that on our doodad, on our bar here. And... what does it look like? Oh, it's a machine. Oh, so... what does help say? $10 to $1, it says nothing. Craft rack rails for cargo lift. Thanks! God, you are so helpful. So what do you need? Doesn't tell you what you need. Hold on, I think it actually says iron here. Craft rail, okay, from iron bars. All right, so, all right, well, I mean, that's something, right? All right, so I'll go grab some iron bars. No point in stopping the recording. It's only going to take me a second. It's right up here. I've got a whole... Actually, I didn't need to do that because I got a whole bunch on me. What I did need to do was build a couple of storage hoppers, I think. Let me just... My cat's trying to get in the room, and it's causing me grief. Oh, yeah, I do have some. Okay, good. Okay, so let's... It's probably going to need power too, probably, because it always needs power. They always need power. All right, so let's get a storage hopper here. Let's put that right beside it, like so. And let's throw, whoops. And let's throw some iron bars in there and see what happens. And it's probably going to say, oh, needs power, because everything needs power. Ah, needs power. Yep. What did I say? All right, so, and we're also going to put another storage hopper on the other side. And just kind of level this out so it's a little bit easier for everybody to see. And we're going to fill this up with juice. Juice for you. Okay. I betcha. Does this thing use a lot of power? How much power is this thing using? Oh, power per second. 85 power per second. Assembling for... Oh, my God. So, okay. I'm going to have to attach this actually to... So, and then how do I put the rails on there? Do I attach the rails via storage hopper? I have no idea. I'll be right back. I'm going to rebuild this. Okay, be right back. Okay, I only had like 1 machine, maybe 2 machines that are capable of producing that kind of power that isn't related to our lab. And that just happens to be over here where we do our plasma stuff and, you know, like infusing plasma into things. So, yeah, it uses 80 some power per second. Like, that's quite a bit, but it's building them super fast. Look at that. Like, 1. Yeah, they build very, very quickly. So we've got 19 rack rails. Now, let's go see what we can do with them. I have no idea, guys. I have no idea. I think we're going to need more storage hoppers, though. More storage hoppers. You know, I don't know how many of these. I wonder if... It'd be cool if it kept track of how many storage hoppers I built. Just out of curiosity. Oh, be right back. I wanted to rebuild this thing. Okay, just give me a sec. Okay, there we go. So I have it actually above the... the shaft right now, and I've got the shaft sealed off on the bottom, and I wanted to kind of have it higher up because I wanted to be able to come up and drop off on my top level, right? So this makes more sense, I think. I don't know what I'm dealing with yet. So we've got 25 of those rack rails, and I just kind of toss them in the hopper here and see what happens. Right, this thing needs power. Okay, be right back. Okay, she's got juice and she's installing rails. Like almost instantaneously, it started putting these rails down, which is great. I think I have to clear that. Is that just one rail? Did it stop? Hold on. How many rails do we have left in here? So use. No, we still have rails in there. So, I have no idea. Oh, I see it creates rails on both sides. Oh, cool. That's neat. So does it just keep going or did it get stopped by that? I don't know. So the wonderful thing about this cargo lift apparently is that it has unlimited range, completely unlimited range, but it seems to have stalled. It seems to have stopped doing stuff. So I wonder if it has to do with this. No. Shouldn't be. It shouldn't be. Oh, I wonder if it has to do with this, actually. Maybe remove this one too. Maybe it just needs a little bit wider berth. I'm glad I tested this with with kind of a mock-up because you never know what you're going to run into with these things, right? So maybe we used 9 rails. Let's go make some more rails. Because, I don't know, maybe we just need more rails. We need more rails. Okay, so let's just, we'll throw in another 100 or something. Yeah. this game is gonna be the death of me. It's awesome. It's so awesome, but there's just so much to do. There's so much to do, and there's so much to learn. That's the other part. It's like, the learning curve on this is pretty crazy. So I wonder if this is a rail, and this is a rail. So, but even so, even if that's the case, maybe I need to rotate. Can I rotate it from here? No, I cannot rotate it. So, I don't know if I could rotate that. Like, how would I build it and have it facing the other direction? I don't know, but I hope it's not because this is in the way. If the other lift is in the way, then I got a bit of a problem. I'm not sure how to fix. I'd have to move the entire shaft. Oh, that would suck. Okay, we've got 25 more rack rails. Let's throw them in and see what happens. Cross your fingers, guys. Cross your fingers. I'm really counting on this working, so... All right, there we go. So, what is it doing? It is... Oh, rail state blocked. Oh. So, it's blocked because of the lift. Are you kidding me? So, I'd have to move the entire shaft, because I've got a shaft already built here. It's already built. It's 3x3, but I can't... Because it's saying that... really? It doesn't make any sense. Because there's, unless it means this, because I can remove this, that's not a problem. If that's what's causing the issue, but I don't think so. I think it's because of the other lift is, it's saying that the other lift is in the way, but it's not in the way. That's a thing. Oh, man. Okay, I'm going to have to rebuild this whole thing. Okay, I'll be right back, guys. I really wish they'd give you more information before you start building these things. It's such a pain to have to... Imagine if I built this entire shaft this episode. Like, I'd built this shaft a long time ago. Imagine if I'd built the entire thing for this episode, realize at the end that no, that's not going to work. Oh, that would be so frustrating. Okay, be right back, guys. Okay, there we go. It's building the rails again. Try this again. So we'll confirm whether or not it was the... Yeah, it definitely was the lift that was in the way. Thing is, it wasn't in the way. There's a block in between them now. It's just, it thought it was in the way. So, that's really frustrating. Really, really frustrating. All right, T. All right, whatever, that's fine. I think we got it working. Now, we have to put the lift on this thing. So, the lift. So, this is, we're just testing it for now. So, it should be blocked now, right? Saying block, perfect. So, now the lift, this is another, now we have to put the actual lift on it. So, it's this one, the basic cargo lift. So, let's put that down. I'm assuming it has to be in the center. What? Hold on. Okay, guys, I've spent a lot of time working on this thing, but I think I finally got it. But here's the thing. So this thing stopped producing rails at about here. And I figured something had to be in the way. I cleared this thing out Like, it's, there's two squares around it that's all clear. It's supposed to be a 3x3 shaft, right? But it stopped producing rails about here. It wasn't until I actually left the game and came back in that it started producing rails again. So now I'm convinced that if I didn't have to actually move the whole thing over, I'm sure if I'd have just quit out and come back in, it would have created the rails just fine right beside the other lift. I don't know why it wasn't working. It must be a bug or something. Somebody, I don't know, we gotta let the dev know, because as soon as I quit out of the game and came back in, it all worked fine. If you need video evidence of what I'm talking about, I could actually, I've got it all recorded, but there's a lot of swearing. Because I was getting so frustrated. I thought for a second that it couldn't pass through this ship that I've been able to walk through and build on top of the whole game. And I was so mad that all of a sudden the developer decided to make it so that, you know, something couldn't pass through the ship. But that's not the case. It was just a bug, and as soon as it restart, it's fine. So now back to putting in the cargo lift. All you have to do to put in the cargo lift, where is it here? I did. I built it again. I swear to God, I built it again. Where'd it go? I just built it. So I lost the other one. I don't know where it went. Again, might be another bug. I don't know. Here we go. Sorry, I hadn't actually. I don't know. The last one disappeared. I came back in after being really frustrated, and it was gone. So to put the cargo lift in, I believe you just drop it in here. There we go. Yeah, so there we go. State unloading order. Unload any depth 4 meters. Oh, there it goes. Oh, very pretty. Ah, stupid laser is always in my eyes. Oh, is that ever cool? Neat. Then I assume that we just have it have storage hoppers beside it, and it just fills up. Very, very cool. I'm moving items, acquiring items. So yeah, this thing has an unlimited range. I am definitely going to be making use of this. This thing might be the answer to a lot of our problems when it comes to moving stuff from one place to another. So I'm pretty excited, relieved that I finally got it working, because like I said, it's been 2 hours trying to mess with it just to find out that it was a bug. As soon as I quit out of the game and I came back in, those rails started placing themselves. They were not placing themselves. They got bogged down. So if you're experiencing a situation where the rails no longer place and there's no reason for them not to place, quit out and come back in and it'll all be fixed. So guys, I'm tired. I'm gonna call this an episode. It's been fun. I'm really glad I got this working. Really glad. I'm excited to actually make use of it. I'm gonna have to reposition it and all that kind of stuff. I'm gonna do all that on my own and get everything working in such a way that it's all functional. Anyway, goodbye Casey. Goodbye Jim Bob. You guys get to know each other better. All right, I'm tired. Goodbye. Take care guys.